So 10th standard, so metals and non-metals, yesterday we discussed the reactivity series of metals, okay. Some of metals are more reactive, some of metals are less reactive, some of metals are highly unreactive, okay. So why? Due to the valency or electrons, okay, donation of electrons or gain of electrons, okay. So today I'll discuss how do metals react with non-metals. So today topic, how do metals metals and non-metals react? So metal example, an example of metal, sodium is one of the metal. So non-metal, so Cl is there, okay. Already we know that, so what is the atomic number of sodium? Sodium is atomic number is 11. Sodium is atomic number is 11. So 2, 8, 1. This is a cell configuration. In a chlorine atomic numbers 17, 2, 8, 7. Actually, this cell having three cells, sodium having 3 cell, but the outer shell having 8 electrons only stable. So now how many electrons there in the outer shell? Here 1 electrons there in the outer shell. So if you 1 electron in the outer shell, but the chlorine, how many electrons in the outer shell? 7 electron is there, but the chlorine gaining 1 electron, 7 plus 1 is 8 is more stable, but the sodium can be lost 1 electron, the outer shell is 8. Okay, so outer shell only need for 8 electrons. These atoms are the atoms or ions are in the atoms are more stable. Okay, the sodium, this metal. Okay, this is a metal, sodium, Na. So 2, 8, 1, then loss of 1 electron to form Na plus. Okay, so 2, 8, loss 1 electron. Okay, the next is chlorine. So chlorine atomic number already neither 17, 2, 8, 7, gaining of 1 electron. So 1 electrons are gain, one gaining of 1 electron. So Cl minus 2, 8, 1. Okay, this electron shell configuration. Now what will happen? 1 electron in the metal, this is a metal, the 1 electron can be lost. The electrons go to the outer shell of sodium atom. Okay, the outer shell of sodium atom. So now the bond formation, the electron, what's the type of bond is there? So actually ionic bond. Ionic bond means what's the transfer of electrons. So 1 electron can be go to the outer shell orbital of chlorine atom. Okay, this is a metal can be react with the non-metal. So metal can be react with the non-metal, but how to find is a 1 electron, 2 electron, 3 electron, 4 electron depends upon the atomic number and valency. So it depends upon the atomic number and the valency. Now I'll discuss some elements with number and valency. Okay, how many electrons are in the K shell, how many electrons are in the L shell, how many electrons in the N shell, and how many electrons and then NOPQ. Okay, so now the first element, the noble gas. Actually noble gas is does not react too easily, because why? For an example, noble gas, one example for helium. So okay, helium atomic number is 2 only. Actually the hydrogen, the helium and hydrogen only, hydrogen 1 electron, helium 2 electron, doublet formation. This is also stable. Okay, but if you 3 electron, if lithium is 3, so 2, 1, okay, this is not stable. If you want stable, you can, the lithium can be lost 1 electron from the lost shell. Okay, except helium only doublet rule. Okay, the next thing, helium, how many electrons? Helium, first element is noble gas, helium. So atomic helium is atomic number is 2. How many K shell, K, L, M and N? So element is helium, number is 2. So K shell having 2, then here 0, here also 0. So no, it does not react easily, because no free electron, only K shell only having 2 electrons is not, does not react to the easily, already stable formation. The next one more noble gas, neon. So neon atomic number is 10. So how to write the cell configuration? So 2, 8, here also stable, the L shell having 8 electrons, so stable. Okay, the next argon. So organ atomic number is 18. Organ atomic number is 18. So out of the electronic configuration, the cell configuration. So 2, comma 8, comma 8. So already stable. Actually, I said the first, you know, last cell having 8 electrons is more stable. The, if 8 electron is there, this atoms or elements or metals does not react with other elements. Okay, due to completely filled. So completely filled. Okay, but here, you know, sodium does not completely fill because 2, comma 8, comma 1 is there. So it can be easily reactive. But here, see 8 electrons there, 8 electrons here, this atoms was not react too easily. Okay. Say, actually, all noble gases are does not react to this easily. They are highly unreactive substance. All noble gases are highly unreactive substance. All noble gases are highly unreactive substance. Now, I will discuss some of the metals. For an example, sodium already discussed. Once again, I will teach. So, metals, the first one, sodium. Okay. The sodium, the first sodium symbol is sodium Na. Atomic number is 11. Then K, L, M, N. Okay. So K shell how many electrons? 2. Then 8. 1. If 1 electron is there, it is more reactive. Because outer shell having 1 electron. So free electron is there. So it can be easily reactive. So sodiums are more reactive. Okay. The next one, magnesium. So magnesium atomic number is 12. Okay. Magnesium atomic number is still, how to write the electronic shell config, 2, comma 8, comma 2. Here also 2 electron is there. Okay, if 8 electrons means unreactive. But the last shell having 2 electrons there. So magnesium also is reactive. Magnesium also high reactive substance, metals. The next one, aluminium. So aluminium atomic number is 13. So how to write 2, comma 8, comma 3. Here also 3 electron is there. So it can be reactive. Then next to potassium. Potassium's atomic number is 19. So how to write the electronic shell configuration? 2, comma 8, comma 8, comma 1. Okay. This is a high reactive only. Okay. Then next one, calcium. Ca. Calcium. So atomic number is calcium is 20. So 2, comma 8, comma 8, comma 2 is there. So this is also the, so calcium also reactive substance. Okay. Then next, the outer mole shell, free electron. They're having free electron. If free electron is there, the valence shell, these atoms or ions, elements are more reactive. Okay. This is more reactive. Next is, these are metals. Okay. Already we discussed the first one, noble gas is metals. Then next, non-metals. Non-metals. So non-metals. Okay. So non-metals, next class I'll discuss you.